Hello everyone, welcome. So in this video we will explain the interface for Blender. Basically this is the 3D world, and this is the outliner, and this is the borders, and this is called the timeline. If you have any experience with After Effects, you will see that you have the timeline, so you can add a keyframe, or you can set the frame for your scene. We will explain that in the animation in the animation section for this class. You have here some tabs. So modeling tab you can use for modeling. So if you have cube, you can go for sculpting and sculpt, UV editing for UV editing, texture paint and shading, and so on. There is a lot of tabs, and you can create your own tab. So if you want to minimize any tab, you can right click and join area. If you will go here, it will minimize the 3D world. If you will go here, it will remove the timeline. And you can click here and drag to make your own layout, and you can drag here. So you can drag here and click here and drag. This may be also 3D viewport, and this may be the dub sheet, or maybe the shader editor. We will explain that, but I now explain how you can move and change your interface. And you can move like this, right click again and join area, so you can join here, and I will join here. There is a Control Alt Q to use this quad view. This is the top. Let's explain what is the top and so on. So the N will display this right windows or right menus, and T will display this left menus. So how we can navigate in the 3D scene, how we can navigate in the 3D window. So the navigation is very simple. Firstly, if you have the mouse, or if you have if you have laptop, you can go to the input and emulate numpad to use because you don't have in your laptop numpad, you will use emulate numpad to use the numbers in your keyboard above the letters to use your numpad. And I am using emulate 3D button mouse, but I will disable this to see the default navigation. So using the middle mouse button, you can rotate. Using middle mouse, you can pan. So I'm using the middle mouse to rotate, and the middle mouse and the shift to pan. Middle mouse and the shift to pan, left and right, up and down. Middle mouse to rotate, shift and middle mouse to pan, left and right. How we can zoom in and zoom out. So it's very simple. You can using your scroll. As you can see, we are now scrolling, and you can use the Alt Shift and Alt. So you can use the Control and the middle mouse to zoom and zoom out. Here is the you can if you are using only the Apple mouse, you can click here and rotate. You can zoom in and zoom out. You can pan the scene. So here you can using the rotate and zoom in and zoom out and the pan. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next video.